What's up, guys? MiddleAgedGamer here. We're playing Train Simulator 2014 Steam Edition, as we always do. I am definitely going to get into some Flight Simulator here pretty soon to break this train simulation habit. Anyways, we got the new West Coast Mainline over Shap route, and I got a request for a cargo scenario. So we're going to go ahead and do the Northern Liner Part 1 using the Class 87 BR Blue. And it says a freight liner trip bound for Glasgow starting at Preston. Part 1 takes you as far as, was it, Tibay at the foot of Shap Bank, and it's autumn 1985. We all love the mid-80s, right? So let's go ahead and get it loaded up. It's about 60 minutes long, so it's medium difficulty. So a very long scenario. Hopefully I don't jack anything up, but let's get into it. Alright, got the game loaded up. It says, we are waiting for clearance onto the goods line at Preston. Please watch your speed over the crossing on approach to the station. Our first scheduled stop is Obeck Loop near Lancaster. The maximum speed of this train is 75 miles per hour. Most importantly, let's get the headlights on, get the reverser forward, and then we're going to go ahead and turn the emergency brake on, or excuse me, the parking brake or locomotive brake. And let's go ahead and test out the brake pressure, build up air in the air brake pipe, as you can see in the middle gauge right there. And we'll release it here just in a second. There you go. Take the parking brake back off, and let's go ahead and start moving forward now. Again, we want to watch that we're not going too high in the voltage right there. Cause major damage to the engine and also give us wheel slip. And don't want to go above 15 right here. Just a little bit, get close to 15, and just under 20 miles to go to the down goods loop. Take a look at our task list real fast. Next stop is just over 19 miles here. A good look at the freight liner here. Definitely not as long as some of the North American freights, but not bad. Got to put my gauge lights on there. It's going to turn those on. This helps us read the gauges just a bit. Wonderful rain effect right there. If you guys are just tuning in for the first time, please, please go ahead and subscribe. I know most of you guys who watch my videos are huge fans. I hate to say fans. I don't believe I actually have fans, but you're huge train enthusiasts. And I know a few of you can even watch the entire video. It's a lot of AI traffic right there. That's pretty insane. Let's go ahead and speed up just a bit. Again, just ensure that we don't get into the red over here. Cause lots of damage to the engine or locomotive, along with getting wheel slip more than likely. And want to pay attention to the speed as well. Definitely a much harder train to get going properly. Got a lot of things to worry about, including neutral zones, speed limits, voltage, but quite fun, especially if you're used to this game. Pretty insane bridge right there. I got a single yellow light coming up, which is not good. Go ahead and start braking. And looks like I do have a red light coming up, so let's go ahead and brake as much as possible here. I'm assuming that's a red light in front of us. Yep, it's still red. I see a train leaving the platform. Not sure if that's on the line I'm on or not, but definitely do not want to pass this signal and ruin my chances for that wonderful, beautiful gold star that we're all trying for. Freightliner cargo there. Looks like we have a green light to proceed forward now. Just want to keep it under 25 just in case. Looks like we got a reduction in speed coming up. And has it stopped raining? Yep, looks like it has definitely stopped raining here. Do a quick train by. Hopefully I don't get any alarms inside the cab that I can't hear on the exterior. See it switching tracks there. Absolutely beautiful background right there. Alright, let's go ahead and get back in cab. Bit afraid I'm going to miss something that I'm supposed to be looking at. Still got a green track ahead, a green signal, which is good. Not speeding, which is good, and we got plenty of traction. Pretty good detailing, modeling in my opinion. This also works, which is pretty cool, even though I've never used it, even on the North American routes. Hopefully they'll put some type of sun glare off in the distance on one of these scenarios one time, where, to the point where you have to use this. Alright, we can go ahead and get up to about 80 miles per hour here. Although I thought the scenario mentioned something about 75 miles per hour as being the top speed limit. Not sure. But I'm definitely going to get up to speed as soon as possible, or as quickly as possible. And one of my YouTube subscribers did tell me this is not the actual traction gauge right there. I believe it's the, was it an ampometer or voltage? Probably should have gone back and took a look. I use it, or I know it, for traction because if you get this too high up towards the red, you're going to have traction issues and wheel slip. But it's actually how much I think electric is going through the motor. I think if it gets too high up, it can actually really, really hurt your locomotive in general. Let's go ahead and run down just a bit because we're picking up quite a bit of speed here. Make sure we don't go too fast, too close to 80. Oh, now we can go up to 110, so I can go ahead and run it back up then. Okay, so 75 is the speed limit there. Sorry, assistant driver, that was something I wasn't aware of. Well, I didn't get deducted for any points there, so I want to thank you, assistant driver. Let's take a look at him real quick. There he is. Great modeling detail right there. Go ahead and speed up just a bit. If you guys are just tuning in for the first time, please go ahead and subscribe yet again. Please comment, like the video, whatever you can do to help me out. I definitely appreciate it. All the money I generate from ad revenue from this channel is donated to Cancer Research Institute. So it's all for a good cause. I'm not going out to any strip clubs or any bars and spending that money that's coming in. I spend my personal money on that. And need not worry, any money will be going to charity at the end of the year. Not sure if I passed a neutral section or not, but I'm not running up anymore. I need to run this all the way back down and back up. Again, I'm triple multitasking here, so I probably did miss a neutral section at some point. Alright, since we're running all the way down, let's go ahead and run up. And it could have been that I was going above 75 as well. My assistant could have been like, nope, that's not something that we're going to do. And just cut the power out from under my feet right there is probably what happened. Damn assistant driver, again, detailing is wonderful, as you can see. Good facial textures and everything else. Just a train by or two real quick. This route seems to run pretty good. Very, very minimal micro stuttering. That's a good train by right there at the bridge. Very cool. So I'm thinking about getting into doing some X-Plane 10 videos. I'm working on it right now. I feel like I have to be a damn pilot to figure it out. But slowly but surely, once I get a little bit better on, you know, I call it booting up the plane, but I think it's called cold and dark to taxiing. They call the plane cold and dark when it doesn't have any electronics going. So I'm learning how to go through the startup procedures and learning how to taxi, how to enter my flight plan. As soon as I can get all that information together, which I don't think is going to be in the next day or two, I'll definitely be making a video with X-Plane 10. I want to take it from like Houston to Dallas starting off, or something in Texas around me. And I want to eventually take it overseas, go from maybe New York to Heathrow at some point. But in all due time, if any of you know how to play X-Plane 10 out there and startup flows, startup procedures, then please let me know. I could use all the help possible out there. For now, I'll be sticking with train simulator so you can see the beautiful scenery on this new route, West Coast Mainline over Shap. I highly, highly recommend buying it if you guys get a chance. I've already had a lot of fun. It's definitely a lot more difficult than some of the other routes due to the neutral zones, and also due to having to watch out for wheel slip and make sure this doesn't go into the red over here. You also have to build up brake pressure or test the brakes to begin with. That's a nice added feature, which gives it a bit more realism. Definitely not for the beginner playing this game, though, because it would be really, really rough to figure it out. I got a whistle board coming up. Take a quick look on the outside here. And we can see the beautiful scenery off in the distance. Really, really good detailing on this route. It was actually not done by the developers. I believe it was done by Crossrails or Crosslinks, which is a third-party developer that made this route. But very, very beautiful. Definitely worth the money I paid for it, I'll tell you that much. Alright, looks like we're coming up to a neutral section here. Let's go ahead and run down all the way. If you guys don't already know, when you get to a neutral section, which luckily usually comes up on the graph below, you gotta run down all the notches to zero, that way there's no power to the locomotive, and then once you pass that neutral section, you can go ahead and run back up. So I'm gonna go ahead and shut this to off right now, that way we don't have any power heading into the neutral section. And once we go through it, you'll hear the electric power down and power back up. We can go ahead and run back up to get back up to speed. So this is one of the added things in the West Coast Mainline over Shap route that adds a bit of difficulty because it slows you down so much. And again, I could have powered down a lot later and saved a bit of speed, but trying to be a little bit safer, be on the safe side. So again, we've got the symbol coming up right here, and we've got two magnets on the ground. We're going to power down and power back up, as you hear right there. So let's go ahead and run it back up. And let's get our speed back up to 75 if possible. If for some reason you're not run all the way down, basically you'll lose all power to the locomotive until you run this down and run it back up. Let's go ahead and run down. Picking up too much speed too fast, and it's starting to sprinkle again. Let's get our windshield wipers on right there. If you guys don't know, I just had my baby girl. It's been an absolute blessing. I've had little to no sleep, but luckily my wife's really taking care of the baby and helping out while I go to work, which is amazing. And she also gives me time to play Train Simulator. Don't tell her that, but she is in some way, shape, or form. Got to keep my fans out there happy. And I truly appreciate you guys if you actually watch the whole video and get through everything. I actually see myself going back and watching other people and even watching some of my videos over again from start to finish. To me, it's pretty relaxing. It's definitely a bit more difficult playing it, but if you're watching the video, you can sit back and enjoy a cup of coffee, as I know some people do out there. You can also, of course, have a beer if you want to as well. So getting pretty close to 75, just want to keep an eye on that. And our ETA doesn't, it says 1723, we don't have an arrival time yet. I'm sure we will get an arrival time, probably right after the 6.8 miles before we hit the first stop. I don't know how to pronounce that. Is it Tebe? Tebe? You and your English people make everything so difficult. Of course, I can't pronounce anything that's American either, so I guess I'm screwed in that shape or form. Anyways, just over 6.25 miles to go. And doing 75, we're making pretty good time on that as well. Do a couple train bys real quick. I know I usually like to stay in cab 100% of the time, but I know a lot of fans out there like to see the exterior from time to time, so I gotta find a happy medium. If it was me playing the game the way I like it, I would definitely stay in the cab 100% of the time, but I do agree with some of you guys out there that it can be a bit more boring doing that as well. Beautiful scenery, beautiful houses. I wouldn't mind living out here. Just because there's not any stations, but just hop on the train, run on it. It's only doing 75. I can run alongside of it and hop onto one of those cargos in the back. At least that's what I'll tell myself. Probably have a few beers before trying. Another thing that's been on the news, we actually had a, looks like a woman abducted here in my small city outside San Antonio. It's a bit strange, no one knows what could have happened. She went on a walk and didn't come back for whatever reason. And they said it's not because of any personal problems of her just trying to get away from the family. They think someone actually abducted her. So they're starting a big search for her tomorrow, and hopefully they do find her, because that's absolutely insane for that to happen where I live. And I'm hoping it's nothing like that. I don't know what it could be. Everything seems a bit strange from what I've been hearing. But God bless that family. Hopefully they can find her. She's only, I think, 33 years old. So very, very young. And I'm very eager to see what happens and if they find her or not, especially since she lives in the same city that I do. Just trying to hold right under 75 miles per hour, and hopefully I'm making good time. Just under 3 miles to go, so we're definitely getting close to the first stop up here. Need to be a bit careful coming in. Just every now and then I'm adjusting the notches, one up, one down, as needed. And I got flashing yellows coming up. Let's go ahead and start running down just a bit, only 1.5 miles, 1.75 miles to go right now. Let's go ahead and start braking now. Stops raining yet again. Curious to see the signal up ahead. Just want to make sure it's not red for any reason. Don't see it offhand, but we definitely need to go ahead and reduce our speed by quite a bit. Single yellow there, that's good, it's what we wanted. And hopefully I'm not running behind schedule. I'm not sure if there even is a schedule in this particular scenario, but I guess we'll find out. Make sure to get under 15 right here. There we go. I guess we'll find out very, very shortly if we're on track or not. A bit nervous. I feel like I've invested a lot of time. I'm going to be pretty scared if I don't make it. That guy's hauling ass. How come I'm not hauling ass? And he's full. Looks like he's doing more than 75 to me. And I'll use my local brake if I end up having to for any reason here. definitely a bit slow. I'm going to stay in cab just in case any more alarms go off. Driver, we are booked to pause here to allow Class 1 Express to pass. Please stop at the next signal. Again, we got another speeder on the tracks, that asshole. Yep, I'm glad I didn't get to the exit here simply because of that. Real quick. All right, let's go ahead and wait for that Class Express to leave. You can see we got the locomotive brake. I got 1 point off for a timeliness penalty is what it looks like, as far as I can tell. Not very cool. Because I'm hoping we got 1 point off. That could be like 601 points or something off. You never know. I guess we only got one more stop, and that's about 35 miles away. Seems like a long distance, but it really shouldn't take that long if we could do 75 most of the time. Is that asshole speeding right there? Looked like me on that Icy Climb video. Cool looking train though, especially since it's from the mid-80s. Let's see how long it takes us to get the green here. To get that cash money green light. Alright, there we go, got the yellow, that's what I needed. Take the emergency brake off, and we can go ahead and start notching up here. Just gonna lay a bit of sander down as well to help me get going. And just wanna stay under 15 miles per hour. That almost caught me off guard right there. Wanted to get up to 110. I looked down at the speed limit and thought, well, that's probably not a good idea. Can't wait till that speed limit goes up. Should be any second now. There we go. I just want to watch the voltage coming in and make sure we don't get above that middle of the double, or excuse me, the middle of the yellow section there. That'd be a good. Or would not be a good day if we did. I feel like I'm stuttering here. Oh well, it's been a long night. Can't blame me. Go ahead and run it down. Looks like we're going to be headed downhill too here shortly. a minute behind from our ETA to our arrival time. So I'm hoping we can pick up a bit of speed here. And we're getting yellow signals already, which is not a good sign. Run down just a bit, picking up a lot of speed here. Trying to be careful through these tight turns right here, make sure we stay under 75. Picking up quite a bit of speed. And we need to go ahead and brake pretty hard here. About to hit a red signal here, and that's not what we want to do. I think the red came off as far as I know. Yeah, we're back to a single yellow. So yeah, I could have definitely got really, really close to running that signal, which is not what we want. Hoping that would turn to a double yellow. I'm still behind it, but has yet to do that. And I hope we're not doing this the entire way there. That'd be pretty bad. Take a quick look on the outside. Really, really good scenery all around us, as you can see. Get back in cab center. We're coming up on a single right now. And just hoping for a double yellow. I don't think I'm going to get that. There's a double yellow. That's exactly what I wanted right there. What would even be better than that would be a green light right now, but I don't think that's going to happen. So I'm just going to keep it cruising around 66, let it go up slowly, and again, hopefully we'll stay on the double yellows here. Slow down just a bit. About to hit a neutral section up here anyways. Going to let it coast just to go ahead and waste a bit of time again looking for that green light or double yellow light. Still on the double yellow, which is good. Let's go ahead and shut this off, and we're going to coast through the neutral section coming up. Again, if you're still tuning in, hey, I really, really appreciate it. Also tuning in to my twitch.tv live stream that we have going on every Saturday. I've been starting pretty late, around anywhere from 7 to 9 p.m. lately. I'm trying to do it at 1 p.m., but I'll always post up that morning when exactly the stream is going to start. That way everybody knows out there. All right, neutral section should be coming up here shortly on the left. You'll be able to see the little sign, and we'll hit the two magnets on the ground. There we go. There's the sign. And just listen for it to power down, power back up. And go ahead and run up just a bit. Still got double yellows. Not going to get or try to get going too fast here. And our ETA is getting closer to the arrival time, which is good. It's making me less nervous about this whole thing. passing a crossing right there. That's a pretty dangerous crossing, especially if the express is going through. Still double yellow. I like double yellow. And there's the green. Let's go ahead and speed up a bit since we're getting the green signals now. Once we get past this signal, we'll go ahead and do a quick train by. Back in the cab because we've got a lot of stuff coming up. Don't want to miss anything, and it's starting to rain again. I want to see that beautiful rain on the windscreen. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. Not being sarcastic, I know I sound like I am. I'm not. It's not my intention. Alright, let's see if we still got a green signal up here or not. Got that green signal. Let's go ahead and pick up just a bit more speed now. Get as close to 75 as we can. Still green, which is good. Lots of AI traffic on this scenario, which is pretty cool. I'm on time, thank you. So I guess I lose 251 points last time, I'm not quite sure. Or 51 points, who knows. I definitely don't know. I definitely don't want to go back and redo it, I know that. I just want that gold star. Now if I don't get the gold star, I'll probably go back and re-record everything. If not, you guys can delight in my misery by not getting 1,000 of 1,000. Praying for that green light again. There we go. Just hitting Q every now and then on the keyboard in case I get a double yellow light up here for any reason. Still green, which is good. That's what I wanted. Looks like we're starting an uphill climb. Go and get back inside. Right, just over 18 miles to go. We got total looking at the task list. We got just about 24 miles, 23 miles to go. Could really use a beer right now. I'm afraid to run to the kitchen and even try it. As soon as I do, I'll probably hit a signal. It requires something out of me. I guess I'll have to stay sober. trying to maintain my speed. ETA right now is good for the arrival time. It's the positive. I would really like to be doing 110 right now as opposed to 74 miles per hour, though, or 75 miles per hour. I do like these banking curves, it's pretty cool. Kind of reminds me of Euro Truck Simulator right there, has that vibe going. For some reason my ETA is climbing even though I'm doing just under 75 miles per hour. Pretty good views right there. Again, pretty cool detail. I wish they had the wires on the overhead power lines right there. I don't think that'd be too hard to render in, but I think that'd be a pretty nice feature. Just take a quick look. I'm afraid to get out of the screen with the signal coming up. Let me look at the signal real fast. Good. Take a look at where we are real quick. We're heading up, so I guess we started down in this area, probably towards the middle of the route. The route. I'd like to know what the hell I'm going to score. I have no clue at this point. Did I lose 51 points? So that's another... Well, that's another 250 right there or not? There's no telling. And just about 19 and a quarter mile to go. Up another small incline right now. Very cool though. ETA is still creeping up slightly. A bit worrisome. And please don't mess up because I need to go to bed. That's what I keep telling myself. Passing them by another cargo train right there. Again, lots of AI train on this route. Doesn't seem to take too many performance hits either when I'm playing it. Let's go ahead and get in before we start going over 75 here. just over 10 miles to go, 16 in total. And we'll see what they have in store for me. Hopefully there's no surprises coming up, or FU moments as I call them. Hit a neutral section in a while. Okay, here comes one. Was it Oxenholm down neutral? So we do have a neutral zone coming up fairly quickly. And the goal here is to lose as little time and power as possible. So I'm going to go ahead and carry it as close to the neutral zone as I can. Let's go ahead and start the rundown right now. That should hopefully be plenty of time. It's going to be pretty close, actually. Alright, we're good. Go ahead and shut it off if we need to. Go ahead and run it back up now. Lost about 10 miles per hour in total. All the way up, just gonna run it up so that we're picking up enough speed. I can kind of control it once we get closer to 75. ETA is now running behind the arrival time still. Just want to be careful on that. I guess I'm not really pushing the limits of the train like I could, but I'd rather be a little bit safe than sorry, especially when I'm this far into a scenario. Just at 6 miles to go. Doing right at 75, making me a bit nervous. I'd rather be just under it. Luckily, we've still got green lights all the way through. Haven't hit any yellows again. Take a quick look at the task list. Definitely going a pretty big incline right here. 10 miles in total to go. Take a quick look from the back of the train, that way you guys can see the scenery. Very cool, seeing it snaking around like that. Go get an end cap so I don't miss anything. Is pretty close in line with the arrival time now, which is good. Maybe I shouldn't stress out so much next time. Just hope I don't get another timeliness penalty for any reason. Really close to the end now. 2 miles to Grey Rig Down. Attention as possible. In fact, let me look at the task list one more time. How far have we got to go? 7 miles, so we still got a bit of time. Just hoping we don't run into any FU moments like I mentioned before. Stopped raining as well, it's going to turn the windshield wiper off. Been raining off and on. This is pretty typical in the UK. Starting to level out or go downhill at this point. It says we're still on time, which is good. Can't tell if we're leveling out, going uphill, going downhill right now. There's just a lot going on. Lots of banking too. Cool. for the signal coming up. Should get be getting pretty close to the end. Yep, just under 4 miles to go, about 3.5. So may have taken a pretty big hit from the start. Maybe getting a 949 if everything goes okay. And it's starting to rain again, which that always helps when I need to stop coming up. And got a flashing double yellow coming up
to prepare for our descent. Just at 2 miles to go. Gonna go ahead and run all the way down and then brake as needed. We actually got a neutral section too, right before the end of the platform. I'm not sure if I need to brake more or not. I don't think I do. Just a bit more. As we hit the neutral section right here. Go ahead and get under 20. And you can see we're switching off the track right here. Take a look at our task list as well, just in case. So we've got to stop in point 18 of a mile. Alright, so we've got to stop at the next signal, I guess. Let's go ahead and stop, and we're going to walk it out real quick. Pretty nice scenery right there. And let's hope for a 9:49. It's exactly what I said. So we did get a pretty big timeliness penalty. So the Glasgow bound express will pass us here, take a break, and then try part two. I think that's a silver, if I remember right. Oh, no, I actually did get the gold, 9:49. Yeah, let's just get the loser of gold and call it a day. So real quick, I'm going to take a look at my career tab real fast so you guys can see that. Let's go back to scenario list. So two golds off two tries, which is good. Not perfect scores, but I guess that's better than going back and redoing the complete video after you've been into it like an hour or two. So career tab, let's open that up, see where I am. I know there's still one guy above me. There he is. Potamus Crime, I think is his name. Level 19 right there. Not too shabby if I do say so myself. Take a quick look to my friends as well. Oop, let me go back. You can see everybody else who's playing on there. Feel free to add anybody on here that you want to. Got a level 14 right there. Bella Duke, how's it going? I think she was on one of my twitch.tv streams. Got 14 pages, so we better roll through this. 10, 10, 8. All good. Lots of practice on those. 13 right there. Fours and sevens, it's all good. Some eights. Anything above a 10 is definitely very, very respectable. There we go. Jonathan D and Spencer. Looking for those silver medals. There we go. Wish they would sort these in order, it'd be a lot easier, right? Couple sixes, not bad. There we go. DPC Productions, level 12, very nice. And that's it. Alright guys, want to appreciate you for watching The Middle-Aged Gamer. Definitely check into my live streams every Saturday. And also please like this video. If you made it all the way through, feel free to leave me a comment and I'll be toasting to that when I see it. Alright guys, take care.